And this is an idea of some of the sizes of pipe that I use. The most common in the stuff that I'm using in that very first video that I made is I'm using 1 7/8 line post for the fitting and then 1.5 inch EMT electrical conduit for the interior. And that fits pretty good. It's a pretty tight fit. The next would be the 1 5/8, and the 1 1/4 fits inside the 1 5/8, and it fits pretty good too. It's not bad. And then you can also use the 1 1/4 for a fitting for 1 3/8 fence pipe, and that fits in there pretty good. And the fitting for the 1 inch EMT is made out of 1 3/8, which fits right inside just like that. And of course the 1 inch EMT, the 3/4, is about as close as you're going to get with that. That's a little sloppy, but that's about as close as you can get. So if you want to make fittings for 3/4 inch pipe, you pretty much have to make them out of 1 inch EMT. There's not a lot out there. And now these are tubing. Technically they're tubing. However, some of them are measured inside diameter and others are measured outside diameter. In fact, the fence tubing typically is measured outside diameter, 1 7/8, 1 5/8, 1 3/8. And all of the EMT conduit and your water pipe and things like that are all measured inside diameter, ID. And the 1.5 inch EMT, 1 inch EMT, and 3/4, of course, are all inside diameters. And all of these pipe are all galvanized. And they're all about 16 gauge, all made out of steel, seam tubing. Now when I set these up, you gotta hold the pipe together somehow. This method here works pretty good. You gotta weld the nut, or the bolt and nut on there. And normally when I put the, when I weld the bolts on there, I use a 3/8 drill bit. And I use a 5/16 by 18 thread count bolt and nut combination. It's in there just like that. I run the threads all the way up on it, set it in there, and that's how I weld them in there. And this can be welded a couple of different ways. You can weld it just in a couple of spots, or you can weld it all the way around. Pretty good. That works really good if you're going to set up and tear down and take the thing apart all the time. Also, this works good if your pipe, if there's a pretty good distance between your two pipes inside, if they're not really tight. What this does is it pushes really hard against the pipe against the other side, so it stays pretty solid once you tighten these things down. Another method, of course, is self-tapping screws. Those work pretty good. You just go through wall to wall. And this method again works better if your pipe is pretty tight. The 1 7/8, 1 1/2 combination, this is usually the way I set it up. The stuff that's sloppy earth, like I say, 3/4 inside of 1-inch EMT, that works better with this. And there is a third method also. If you're setting it up permanently, you can just simply drill completely through and put about a 5/16 bolt through there and a nut and completely bolt them. And obviously, in the wind, you have to keep these canopies on the ground. And the most secure method I've found for attaching to, say, decking or concrete is to just make an actual base plate like this. That's a 4-inch by 4-inch plate on the bottom. Now that's 1 7/8 line post. But that is pretty secure. The other method, if you don't want to bolt it down, is to make a big concrete weight and attach that to each one of the legs. 5-gallon buckets, you can use a 5-gallon bucket. You can make the sleeve to go inside the 5-gallon bucket out of the 1 7/8 or whatever corresponding pipe you're using. And that way you can remove the weight from the leg itself. You can just put a section of this pipe in there, and all you have to do is pour the concrete in. You don't have to put anything on the concrete or anything, just the same way they pour fence, they make chain link fences. And then just drill it and bolt it, or use a self-tapper and keep it on the ground. The weight method works good if you're renting the house or if you need to move it or something. But like I say, actually physically bolting this thing down to the ground is the most secure. This is a fitting that I make once in a while. What this is basically a half saddle. And I take these and I take the pipe and I cut it in half on my bandsaw. And what this does, it allows me to add something later on. Once you get them put together, sometimes they're not so easy to just take one part out or, you know, replace one or two pieces, especially with a bigger pipe. Smaller pipes, not bad, 3/4 inch, and sometimes even 1 inch, you can get one fitting out of the canopy. But normally with the 1 1/2 inch, the only way to get a fitting out is to take the whole canopy back apart to the point where that fitting is. So. If I need to add something later on, typically I'll do it with a half saddle like that. Now this is a different way to actually manufacture a canopy fitting. You could mandrel bend the pipe to whatever angle. In this case, it's actually a 30 degree angle. And that's consistent with a wall tent for hunting or a greenhouse or something like that. The problem you run into is the manual benders that they make for pipe. Once you get beyond 1-inch EMT conduit, it's a little tough to bend it by hand. They sell benders. You could buy them at Harbor Freight. They got a hydraulic bender. I'm not sure how well that's going to work on tubing, though. It's you don't want to kink the stuff. And you can see this one here. And it's this is set up for 1-inch pipe. This is about 1 3/8 inch chain link fence, probably, or roughly the same size as that. But you can see there, you know, if you had some bigger pipe and you really wanted to bend it like that, probably the best thing would do go to your local muffler shop and ask them what they would charge you to bend your pieces, and then take them home and weld them when you got done. And like I say, this 30 degree angle is kind of a little different. The first canopy that I showed was a 20 degree angle.